Hey guys, well, I was gonna bring three people this time, but you actually need two tanks this time, and you'll see why. But not as a physical cover tank is not needed this time, but you do need to provoke with them, obviously. Otherwise, why would you be here? But you do need, unless you can raise some resistances, you can do that too if you wanted. But you do need a cover tank this time, I believe. Pretty sure of that. Now, let's see if you survive this time. He hits really hard, that's for sure. Now we survived this time just fine. Remember, one of the missions is no death, so you have to do what you can do. Oh, well, he died, I guess. I'm assuming he's only defensive. Spirit breakable just like the other ones, but if he's attack magic breakable, definitely want to do that. Even with my tanky CG wall there, he was taking over 1000 damage per hit or more. The magic tank is needed, or else your units most likely will die without buffs of some kind, because he hits hard with that magic attack. So guys, I know this is very quick, Basically, when you're playing on the global side, you do all these things to upgrade this weapon. It's still bad, but it's a free weapon that's decently attacked. The passive is useless, though. It's just a normal attack buff, just like the regular lightning's TMR. It's bad, so you get all the crafting materials from those trials that we just did, and you craft this. So that's really it. So I hope you guys enjoyed using more units that I don't get to use very often, but I like using the VP units. Oh, and the rod is pretty good too, actually. It'll come in handy because it has 25% physical and magic. Well, physical doesn't matter, the magic demon killer, so that'll be nice. Anyways, guys, I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.